Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, I got to tell you about the fabulous, most groovy Bell Bottoms. Bell Bottoms.
Right, Haribo, you were shit.
Would
but
you
I mean,
believe?
Everybody else kind of sucked as well. Except for Michael.
Hooray!
Okay, everybody go home. We'll see you next year.
I can't get a moment's peace round here. Snow in May. Odd. You may think I'm happy, you may think I'm sad. Rap. I was born on the 7th of May. I remember very well that. I was in a band playing drums. When I was 6, I ate a bag of plum. Grey, really grey. Kids like Christmas. Let's play, shall we? You see, once I went to the fridge, saw an old sausage roll, and I thought, probably still edible, so I grab it. It's no good, I can't. It was then I noticed it was frozen to the shelf. Then I give a yank with my arm, and that's the way it goes down. Oh no! Kaboom! I was crushed by the fridge. I could feel the weight digging into my body. I could feel my bones bursting. Anyway, the doctor had to amputate my body, so that's why I don't have one at all. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Wow! But how about this baby picture, huh?
What did I say about questioning me?
Hey, I think your ball is dirty. Try cleaning your pouts.
When are your parents or whatever coming to get you again? Nice. Once my brother said, why don't we do precisely nothing for your birthday treat? We could spend all day at home looking at the telly. It'll be great. Yeah, I said, it'll be great. Mum said, absolutely. So we put her on a plane to Jamaica and then we went home. When we got there, my brother found out that there was this bastard who took our money at the door. Hey, come back here. We're gonna catch the little... Whoosh. I don't believe it, I really don't. And then we get the milk. I mean the money. And everything was lovely once again. Michael, that ending was way too anticlimactic.
I don't care.
I like you. You're like a brother to me. So sad. Nice. Nice. Glasses, you wanker. I'll make you eat those words. I need back that white now. Stand down now, and we won't have to kill you. You underestimate my powers. Even more, do it. He can't run for long. You can't use the same move twice in one video. I see them down the road.
Copy that.
And he's watching.
Face the facts, so this is your death.
That's a damn minigun. Useless. Yes. I've got to do it. Oh no. I sure hope that was the last of them.
You are surrounded from either side.
Let's do this. What do you say to that?
I say we're just getting started.
In that case, bring back the Matrix music. I've got to find out how to do this. One's mine. Come on, Red, let's end this. Got it.
And so my dad says, that was quite rude.
You can do this, Michael. Oh no! Rock, paper, scissors, damn it!
Look at that.
Slap! Once you get like that bum of yours, I'm out the window.
What's that?
What?
Ow!
I'm still here.
What do you think of my glasses now, motherfucker? Actually, I was talking to the person behind you. Oh. Nice. I saw something else. I was starving. All I had for
breakfast,
it was half past nothing. And I had to get to Hempstead. So I bought a pita.
No.
So I bought a pita.
That's enough.
So I bought a pizza. I began to eat. Trouble was, I was kind of attracted to the pizza. I don't want to eat the pizza anymore. I want to make it my girlfriend. And Haribo said, you can't do a wet. I mean, you can't catch me. I mean, you can't do that. Shut up! I'll eat whatever the fuck I want. Thank you very much, Haribo.
So here goes.
In goes a bit of pizza. Actually, I think I'm allergic. The moment I dread when I can't even eat up my own girlfriend.
Yeah, I'll come up with you that.
Never mind. Hey, Michael, have you tried taking the bones out the pizza? How the fuck can the pizza have bones, you fool? I don't know. Just try to take them out anyway. Okay, here goes. Why are you breathing in? Oh no. Oh no, and what? He's choking. I can't get a moment's peace from here. Does anyone see? Hey, it worked. But hang on one sec. How could bones fit inside my throat? What's going on? Can I just eat my pizza now?
Okay, yeah?
No!
So sad. I cried. Then I started
crying.
We said a soup. Anyway, my mum bought a pizza and she says,
me too.
And I say, well, I hate pizza. All slippery and sticky. And the pizza didn't make any noise at all. My mum says, don't you talk like that. So I said, whoa! Ah, that was my spine. Deep down inside. I'm okay. With a little pizza stuck in my throat, it's sticky.
Whoa!
So I start to suck. So I think, well, actually, I make my teeth cut into the pizza. It was then I noticed the woman opposite. It was my closest maternal ancestor, and she said, eat three as one as well. And I said, it's way too fucking sexy. I never did eat that. Well, actually, I did. But then I remembered this funny little thing. I was still allergic. It was then I noticed nothing, because that's a lazy way to transition. Anyway.
Don't you talk like that. Don't you dare so. When I was a girl, I had to eat what. You know, there are some people in the world who give their right.
Go away. Michael, we have something to make you better. Are there any side effects? Bag of plums. I think I'm better now. Anyway, thanks for watching. Plus, oh no. Nice. Increase voluting. Yo. Big Mike. Drog sauce. It's another one. They say one and one is two. That was me and you. But wait, stuck like glue. Aha! Boom. I like my eggs with a scrambled tin, but please don't burn my toast. She wants me to be her bloke, but she can't cook Sunday roast. Ah! You can't get my eye. You looked in my eye. When I walked eye. Cause you know that I'm fly boy. They call me. Let's turn you and I to a. She said, boy, you're silly. Then ran for the bus quickly. No oyster, I didn't chase it. I just jumped in for it and I faced it. She started laughing. What a bitch. Anyway, sorry. I didn't have time to finish it and I can't be arse. Well, actually, it was due to other condiments. Yeah. Not bad for a first time, but hey, yeah? Anyway, happy birthday, Michael. Have a good one, mate. Nice.
Black. Dylan.
Was described, tells us what's important to him, like limp wood coming sea. And the well, he describes it, helps us feel the cock.
Trans rights are human rights.
Hot food.
No pain.
Really hard. Do more work. To me.
Semolina.
Subscribe.
Afterglow.
Lime. Time. Boing. I'm
gay.
If you're making up your own words, the words can remind you of the thirds.
Lord, me thought, what?
Are you? Go to hell.
Hello. I'm an ex-incrabby. Click.
We're trying to collect together the beginnings of a shit.
The Billy Bully.
Nice. Kaboom! Well, looks like it's time to go to school. It's my birthday tomorrow. I think Ryan told me he was planning something wonderful for my birthday treat. So I've got to be here. Yes, I know Michael is British, so he should be drinking tea, but that isn't what we're talking about now, is it? And off we go. Right, Class 6. Right, Class 6. I'm talking. I want complete quiet. Right. As you know, it was our plan to go out today to the...
Shit.
I think I left my folder at home. Maybe I put it in my desk.
I need to tell you. Yes, you as well, Abdul. You're in Class 6 as well, aren't you? I saw that, Mark. I saw that. Any more, and you'll be out. No trip, nothing.
Blimey.
Oh no, this is horrible!
Has anyone seen Michael Rosen today?
I've been up here for 3 weeks! I've been wet! I've been nibbling my toes!
What? Boom. What is this place? So nice. Yes! You promised me plums, so where are they?
Look.
I'll give you a bag of plums if you listen right here.
Okay.
I need you to help me escape. What do you mean? I'm being held hostage.
Ha! Nice try, bitch.
Help me, someone. Class is almost over, and I still don't know where Michael is. I remember I saw him this morning, and then he was gone. I thought he'd tell someone where he was going. I hope he's okay. What? Why did you put me here?
Well, I'm trying to get rid of all the overused YTP sources. And you put the last Rosen left. That I'm dead. I just need to turn on my detonator. Get rid of you all.
What's in my pocket? Butter. This really long spoon. Hopefully that made the bar more slippery. You press the silver button. Hooray!
What is going on?
Follow me.
You won't get away that easy.
Prisoner detected. Commencing deditizer sequence.
Oh no, this is horrible!
Hmm.
button.
What is it?
Well, see you guys later. Of course, this had to happen just before his birthday. Something always seems to happen on his birthday. I wonder why. Boom. Where in the world? It's a really long story.
Warning! This is a story
all about how my life got flipped turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how they made me king of the fools.
Ah, there's that. Stop.
Let's make this birthday a
fucking crazy
treat, shall we?
I was born on September 5th, and I've been really hot all day. I was in my mother's bed at 5th, and I have to say we've got that.
May, a woman called Ma'am. But there I was.
Welcome back to the last part of the last right stuff of the week, where I'm joined by esteemed children's laureate Michael Rosen, author of such classics as We're Going on a Bear Hunt, The Sad Book, and his latest FCC.
I'm the chairman of the FCC.
Out! One of the great things about butt sex, you know, people sit in airports and you see people starting to kind of go. And it went flying out.
Once my brother said, I like butt sex, and then he just fell over and died. Oh, and then his Richard got long and hard.
Island, there's an NPC who states, "We're going on a berry hunt. We're going to find a big one," which I immediately recognize as a reference to an extremely popular show. We're going on a bear hunt. We're gonna find a big one.
Now let me introduce you to two facts about me. Fact one, a block Billy Bob 125 on Twitter, and fact two, I'm Michael Jackson. Again? Come on. Well, since I'm here, why don't I read this letter for me? Dear Best Street Plumbers, wrong letter. Dear Michael Rosen, happy birthday. I went on a bear hunt, found a bear, and it was thick, sweet juice. That was good. One, how wonderful. So now I'll enjoy my birthday treat. So may I drink and chocolate cake. Cool guy and cool guy. Cool guy met cool guy going down the street. Said cool guy to fool guy,
what the f*** are you looking at?
Said fool guy to cool guy,
hey SA, I'm breaking into your car.
Said fool guy to cool guy, once I went to the fridge and I thought,
what's in it?
Syrup. Lift the jug and fill my mouth with that thick suck juice.
Bitches come from a can. They were put there by a...
Wow! The acid trip.
Oh.
This is a long car journey. I'm dry out and I can't dry out properly if you two are going in the back.
Ouch!
Okay, Mum, okay. Don't worry about it.
12 seconds later.
We start the mo-mo. Can I have a drink? Can I have a sweet? I want a drink. I want a drink. Can I have a drink? Look out the window. There's a
train.
Anyway.
And all the time, my brother is not taking any notice of Michael. The front door opens.
Who can it be knocking at my door?
Hello?
Oh, no. The moment I dread when Dad goes from being cheery to absolutely furious. In a weedy little voice, I say,
knock, knock.
Who's there? The door.
No. We saw more plane. And more planes. And more planes. Yep.
Moving to the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches.
Oh, that's hot. That's hot.
Nice. The Michael Rosen rabbit. You may think I'm happy, you may think I'm sappy, you may think I'm crappy, you may think I'm mad in. I'm telling you, that was a puzzle. One. She said I hit the dog when I was playing six. I was so fed up because I hate her now. Sus, 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 slam, bam, boola, balamda, diddy, boom. And there was always a whiny kid going, meh, can I go, can I? There was a school prison underneath the school hall where they used to string you up from your ball sack. Awful. The little, shiny bum of yours stuck in a chair. I like it when you go to those places where I saw something else. It said, the Hollywood. So I said, I'll have a Hollywood. Dad said, waste of money. He won't eat it. Mum said, go wash your slime, you cock. If you want, okay, yeah. A Hollywood, please. And we waited for 3 hours and all the time. My dad's saying. And then my mum says, once you get that bum of yours stuck in a chair, you never stop whining, do you? And my dad says, after the war was over, everyone came, baby, boom. Anyway, happy birthday, Michael Rosen. Balam bam boola, balam da diddy. Nice. Could you get me the milk?
Why did you have to sing? You know, kind of unnecessary if you ask me.
Look, I just really want some milk in my tea.
Oh, if you want.
Yes.
Okay.
Thanks. Ocean man, take me by the hand. Yeah, I'm a bit short. Nice. Today I'm talking to the and former Blackman, Mallory Blackman. Mallory, hello.
Ha.
So let's just begin with a very general question. What's your question?
Part of the reason I love my job is because I'm on a new part of my story and I'm exploring. Because it was around the time that my parents split that, and so I was. And if you just do a page a day, in a year you'll have 5 pages. So it is this thing of you just have to sit down and shit and have the discipline to do.
And when you're away from the shitting, so I'm imagining you sitting there for an hour. Let's imagine you're in the middle of a shitting, middle of a big dump. I mean, obviously you're doing all sorts of other things like eating and
breathing.
Goodness knows what. But do you do
oh,
some?
God, yeah.
Yeah.
The majority of shitting. I'm kind of just in my own head and in my own head and in my own head and in my own attic. And I remember when I was at school and I'd always be getting told off, Mallory, could you stop looking out the window? And
look out the window,
please. And I love kind of having conversations with
the two-year-old. See if you can go back to the beginning where a little spark happened in your head and you thought,
This book came about because I read a newspaper article. And it was a newspaper article. And it was written by a Doctor Who. And it was written by a Doctor Who said that it was a newspaper article. And it said that we'd have to start using animal cocks because there's such a shortage of human pigs. And there was actually a place where they had started breeding these genetically modified pigs, ready to put their pee into pigs, but they couldn't get a government license to do it.
Why?
Because...
So these books, most of them seem to be books, most of them seem to be about a kind of a penis. I'm sort of... Tell us about endings.
Well, you know, die, Michael. Well...
Today we're talking to David Alexander. There's no David. You don't know David, famously for this book, Skellilex. He's got a damn new picture book out called The Dam. And he's going to be talking about some other damn books in just a damn minute. And so, David, welcome to my channel.
Hello, mate. Oh, sorry.
It's been lovely talking to you.
Yes, thank you.
Hello. Well, today I'm joined by Frank Cottrell Boyce, who, as you can see, is Frank Cottrell Boyce. So, are you Frank Cottrell Boyce at the moment?
I'm not robot. Yes.
I'm immediately thinking, wouldn't it be great if I was a robot?
Oh, wouldn't it be great if you found a little boy and it was yours and you could do what you liked with it? But what if you were a little kid and you found a massive, you know, what would you do with it? So we live surrounded by invisible, drunk, rushing robots that we don't really think about. You know, there are robots all the time, doing time. And he's not really a robot. It was just a kind of mechanical robot. It was just a kind of mechanical robot. But he was really a robot.
Is it naughty?
It's a piece of, you know, it's
Without giving too much away, I can imagine something might go seriously gay.
Really gay, you know? Good. So you can't really kind of say, just get behind the ass, you know, or I'll feed you.
Little bit of a whirly effect there. Whirly effect. Well, I don't think we have that. We haven't got a whirly effect.
No, I'm kind of editing it at the moment, but because I came on the train, I found... How I thought is I'm taking a crap on the train. Like, have
Let's
an
wave
idea.
That crap about so people can smell it. Why should I think Liverpool is great? Oh, yes. Do you know I've launched a new specifically aimed at Liverpool? There was me doing a teacher.
We used to do dicks, and the teacher would say... You know, choose a place to stick your dick. It could be the eye or us or whatever.
I did the ducks in the park.
There you go.
The whole of that opening.
Animal facts. Cows can walk.
Oh my goodness, that's awful for them. Because, I mean, you know, you could turn up at someone's toilet for tea. You go upstairs because the bathroom's downstairs.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to think of the last goat I met. Actually... Yeah, your sister.
Did you know that Mike is short for Big
I don't think he needed to mention that, folks. He knows I'm an asshole.
The other thing, I think, is that you steal from other people and...
I'm distracting you at this very moment.
Yeah, that's why I want to go. I want to make sure I'm doing on the train on the way home.
Einstein says, "Hi, Michael. My 4-year-old son, Alfred, put one of those little chocolate Swiss rolls in his pocket and he wants to ask you, Michael Rosen, do you like trains?" No. Frank, do you like trains?
I love trains. That's a cliffhanger.
Nice. Right, Mick? You look for something special to eat for your birthday treat. No, yours, you fool. I'm just trying to rhyme things. Just find something. Yeah, okay. I like that. I got a Benedict Cumberbatch.
What? Oh, sorry.
Prick. Did you see any takeout box around here? Something the matter?
What do you want?
You heard me, didn't you?
Just wanted to know if you saw my dinner.
No.
You doing okay?
Why do you ask?
Just wondering. I mean, we haven't talked in a really long time.
I'm all right, leave me alone.
Okay. Just wanted to know what you've been up to.
That's none of your business.
Sorry, dear, sorry.
What did I do specifically? Are you serious? Hey, I live here. You can't just take my house away.
Yes, we can.
Okay, what now?
What?
Oh, bloody hell, you're still here?
Yeah, I wonder who put that there.
Who put what where?
You see that sign over there? I don't think it was there before.
Could be.
Do you want me to help you get that thing back?
I can probably handle it myself.
Do you even know where to start?
Don't you have anything better to do now? Isn't today your birthday?
Well, actually, it's tomorrow. Something wrong?
No.
Okay, why don't we go to the station?
All right, sure. Hey, there it is.
That's a big parking boot.
Yeah.
Right, we need to find a way to force this thing off.
Now, wait just a minute. There's got to be an easier way. Maybe there's someone who can help in that office.
But they put up a fake street sign.
We don't know that for sure. It's worth a shot.
All right.
Hey, how can I get that parking boot off my house?
No.
What do you want from me?
Over
$9,000!
What's Rog doing here?
Hi, I'm augmented reality Rog. The future of the future.
Alright, lovely, thank you.
Told you.
Shut your face.
Anyway, while you were in there, I came up with a plan to go out today.
What do you have in mind?
I think you know what I melted. Fiddle diddle. Riddle.
Okay, enough of this.
I didn't know you can drive properly.
What about the time you thought I was Lollipop Lady? I could drive then.
Look at what those guys left here.
We're gonna get in so much trouble. Let's just find a new spot for my house.
Good thinking.
I wonder how many people are going to have a car chase like this in their entry.
Entry for what? What are you going on about now?
Never mind. Just rambling to myself.
Look out!
Stop! You violated the law.
Well, who could have seen this coming?
Yeah, he can violate this.
Michael, don't do it!
You violated the law! You violated the law! You violated.
Yeah, that wasn't so bad, was it?
How do you know the gun would do that?
I don't know.
Alright, whatever. Let's just go. Now, you're absolutely sure nothing's gonna happen to this place?
Yes, I had my brother look at the street sign and he told me I was right. It was fake.
Oh, the indignity.
Get out of my office!
For... Anyway, working on anything these days?
Not really.
Nothing at all.
I mean, I've tried to get back into it a few times. Just haven't been properly motivated for ages.
Jeez.
Yes.
That's a shame.
Although, I do have a work in progress from a few months ago.
Oh, let me see.
All right.
Nasty. Some people say roads aren't wrong. You'll never guess who said that. The Minister of Wrong. Zobra zebra.
Zobra zebra. Zobra zebra.
I was knocked sideways. Look, chum, she said, haven't you anything better to do than hang about on street corners?
No.
So I went off into a street corner and hoped to die, and I never came back from the hospital. You're a lolly, they tried to make out. So I went off into a bread shop with a duck on it, bought a hot chicken pie with a duck on it, went through the gate with a duck on it, turned left and there was the Minister of Wrong. Right, she says, we're all going to swear in front of old Grandad. All hell will be let loose on him. Hell. The stop children thing. You look like a fair copy of one. Good. We could do it in six different colours, says one of them. Doesn't have to be black and white, does it?
Well, of course it does,
Vi says. And the other thing we've got to do is fighting the giant trucks. And the other thing we've got to do is make a lolla. And the other thing we've got to do is make out. Vi, I said, you're wrong. You're the Minister of Right. Every now and again, she was having to stop me talking because there'd be a giant truck. Pshaw, pshaw, pshaw. Stripping a great white slosh across the giant truck in the dead of night. Now, what else? We counted up. It was chaos. A policeman turned up, went away. Two policemen turned up, went away. Six policemen turned up, went away. 12 policemen turned up, went away. As many policemen as you need to fill the road turned up when fighting the giant ducks.
That's pretty much all I got.
I suppose that wasn't too bad.
Well, happy birthday and enjoy the other hours of birthday messages.
What? Nice. At school, we were doing, you know the kind of thing, the doings. Transport. Wood. Our project was, and I wrote to eat a fucking tomato. There we were trying to work up the courage to eat some tomatoes. It's no good. We can't, so we went up to our teacher and we say,
we
don't like the project very much. And the teacher says, spots in my pot. So I only put a little bit on my fork and I bluff. And there's my brother, he's doing the same. Stop it. Tink, tink. And we're sitting with tablets. And my dad wants milk in his teeth. Oh! Could you get me the milk? I get you. Milk. I get. ChattiestDrum, a sad excuse for a human being. Actually, I'm a cat. We live in a flat. Over a flat. Over a cat. Mum comes at 10 to thumbs. When I wait for her, I washing up. That was an awful transmission. Right. We've cooked the dinner. You two can wash it up. I said, I don't want to wash my dinner. Then she said,
it's the
pneumonia. My brother has pneumonia. And the house can't shut up. The Michael Rosen. Once my friend came to school crying. We said, What's the matter? And he said his granddad didn't know what to say. Then I said, that's no crying matter. And he said, he has all behind us, you dick. And then he started crying again. Nice.
I'm tired.
It's the 7th of May. Oh shit, Michael's big day today. What am I gonna do? Woo!
You didn't get me any birthday presents.
What are you doing?
Oh, you know.
What? Ow! My toes. Choch, 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 choch. Choch, choch, choch.
What's that?
Oh, Sky.
Shut your damn boobers.
Yeah, that'll do.
Did you get Michael anything for his birthday?
Oh, 2 minutes later.
Quick, quick, quick. You're too slow.
I can't drive That's properly.
What? Where is...
Yeah, there it is!
Mom, I want one. Look!
This is my switch. Buy your own.
Nice.
Whoosh.
I've never, ever been as tired as this.
Oh, hi guys. Happy birthday, Michael. For me.
Yes.
Here, Michael. Yeah, I'll come off at you lot. I've got another one of those little text-to-speech letters again.
Dear Michael, happy birthday. We hope your 73rd is another great birthday for you, filled with lots of love, laughs, friends, family, and most importantly, chocolate cake.
With much love, the pupas. Thanks, first aid.
Oh, my one now.
Okay.
It's good. Have it, it's nice.
But I wanted to switch.
Oh, sorry, you only got 2 gifts this year, Michael.
About that.
Well, don't expect us to buy you presents ever again. Now I'm angry.
Okay, we got them.
Nice. Nice.
Michael Rosen 73rd birthday collaboration. Anyway, stop this right now. Got it.
Who are you?
Get off me! How did you really think I was done? Lord, no. That wasn't all that you're getting from me this year. This following bit is probably gonna be the main part of the entry. I don't know, but there we are.
Good job, good job. Hope to see more from you like that.
Well, Lamb's Joker, I'll certainly try. What the food am I doing? You may think it's a bit redundant to have a birthday collab every year if I look the same age in everyone. That being said, I don't want to stop using this range of sources. If you see me staring at a white wall, I mean, if you see me sticking to the same old poems, that's what I'm doing. Anyway, here goes, says. Fritch, but okay. Dad doesn't shave and his prick is all hairy. If they have those hot air things, shall we? Needy little voice. They're nibbling my tomato one nails. More and more planes. More planes. More planes. Two nails. More and more people in Britain couldn't be bothered with toenails anymore. Blunt and in theory, but since about 11 years ago, people have started using fingernails. We spoke to hacking me fucking arm off of kneecap. Yeah, I like fingernails. I've got 5 of them. Be like hack. Be cool. Throw toenails out. Tones. We sit down and the air's a bit hot and I blow. Till it's cool, just cool, then into the mouth. Warms your lungs up, that does. Ha! Ableton is better. A girl said, someone told me a joke I didn't understand. So I said, was it funny? And she said, I don't know, I won't get it till tomorrow. A boy said, I'm really glad my mum called me that. I said, why is that? He said, because all the kids at school call me that. Useless information.
Help me, someone.
Once my friend Harry Boat said he couldn't think of something to talk about. So he didn't know what to say. Then I said nothing because I didn't want to contradict myself to own a foil elf. Conversations with a really self-obsessed bugger. Do you want an apple? Me. Can you hear me? Me. But dumb crash. The advertiser. Books on the internet. The woods. We went to this tank and I had loads to eat. Well, actually, I had one sloppy goldfish dead on my plate. Really, that I scooped together and pushed into my mouth. It was the simply edited bit to help me get to the 5.5 minute mark, which was nice.
Which was nice.
Oh no! Looks like I'm out of ideas. So here goes. Conversations with a 2-year-old. Do you want an apple? No! What do you want then? I want for you to stop with this rehash of a joke from last year and just get to the closing message. Okay, I said okay. Yeah, okay. Now we'll turn out all the lights. Well, another year's gone by as quick as the last one did. It's funny. It still doesn't feel as though it's been a year. Does it? Michael, I hope you'll have a lot of presents and have a great time. After all, today is your day. Maestro, some music, please.
Last funny. And then, in the middle of the night, I woke up and I thought, whew, I'm tired. And I go to sleep.
Okay, we've got...
Nice. The way they slide round your mouth. Ooh. Ooh. Ah, ah. Ting. Ting. Bang. Ooh. Ooh. Ah, ah. Ting. Bang. Okay then.
Anyway, today it's the anniversary of the time I got expelled from a birth canal. But now, I need to come up with ways of celebrating it with the poems that I write. Watch out, everybody. The screen's about to turn white. I want to tell you about
nobody
a
Nobody cares.
And right, left. Who wants a plum original? You may think I'm a he, but hang on to your seaside on their own. I'm going to tell you something that'll burn your box. A hip hop, bright green top. And there was a, and when you press the silver button, a little disc tray slid open, and you put the disc in, shut the tray, and then we start the game.
Hello! Just making sure you were using Wi-Fi and not mobile data.
Bro's pizza. Would you believe? Anyway, my mum and dad tried something new.
I think you know what I mean.
I'm talking about sex. Right in the mouth. It was like, my dad was in my mother. Boom. Kabang. I have to tell you how to behind the book, behind my dad, behind the door, behind the curtain, behind our desks, behind you. Kaboom. No. Fridge. Deep down. God, when I get inside, he's gonna be dead. God, when I.
Michael!
I'm a bit fucked up, he called him. When I was one, I swam to the fridge. When I was two, I was a 2-year-old.
We know
when
that, you
I
fool.
Was three, I started getting back onto the table. When I was five, I was in a bus playing music really loud, like a little fucker. When I was six, I ate a bag of bag. When I was seven, I was eight, nine. When I was eight, I was nine,
ten. Well.
Anyway, I think it's time to wrap the video up.
Danny Fenton, he was just 14 when his parents built a very strange machine.
It was designed to view a world unseen.
He's gonna catch a mold disease, Danny Fenton.
When it didn't quite work, his folks, they just quit. But then Danny took a look inside of it.
There was a great big flash, everything just changed.
His molecules got all rearranged. When he first woke up, he realized he had snow white hair and glowing green eyes. He could walk through walls, disappear, and fly. He was much more unique than the other guy. And it was then that he knew what he had to do. He had to stop all the ghosts that were coming through.
He's here to fight for me and you.
He's gonna catch a mold disease, Danny Phantom. He's gonna catch a mold disease, Danny Phantom. He's gonna catch a mold disease,
Danny Phantom.
Nice. Just wanna eat raisins. Raisins just for you. We just wanna grow toenails. Toenails just for you. I know you wanna eat raisins. Raisins just for me. Eat raisins and potatoes. Why? Need a tree. Yeah. We just wanna eat raisins. Yeah. Raisins just for you. Yeah. We just wanna grow toenails. Yeah. Toenails just for you. I know you wanna eat raisins. Yeah. Raisins just for me. Yeah, eat raisins and potatoes. Yeah, why need a tree? This is the sky Google. Don't catch you being cool. My sister is a fool. I don't go to school. This is the sky Google. Don't catch you being cool. Lollipop on the stool. My brother has a cool. This is the sky Google. I saw him in Iran. Lemonade in the can. I'm afraid of Japan. Yeah, this is the sky Google. I saw him in Iran. I'll be your milk man. I like snacks. Yeah, burger, wait the drums. Yeah, this is Hollywood. Yeah, burger, eat the plums. Yeah, the bee in the wood. Yeah, I'm so boring. Hey! Don't wanna breathe. I'm so happy. This is the sky Google. Don't catch you being cool.
Don't catch you being cool.
That's King K. Cool. Don't trip on the stool. This is the sky Google. Yeah. Don't catch you being cool. Nice. Boom, boom, boom.
The Skyfugl has escaped!
Nice. Hi everybody, it's your source, Dick Ian. First of all, random stuff. When I tell fibs, she calls me Smelly Mick. When my children's shoes have fart, I start to sing. Yeah, Postman Mike, in his black and white bike. Yeah. Right, as you know, I wrote a book called Where B Was Looking for Wood. Maybe I shall rephrase that. I mean, Dick, what did you lick?
I won't translate that.
I mean, my Haribo's horrible secret.
For God's sake!
Not long after, 10 years later,
we're back!
This is the day before before
happy birthday to Michael Rosen.
I'm very old, but not actually as old as Queen Juliana. Is a bum. Enjoy yourself. Coming, funny.
Dave, what's my name?
Asshole.
Hard luck.
Dave. The Hollywood orange.
Good.
Breathing.
Oh, I just burped there, sorry. Portuguese, not sweet. Gay ass. And back off plans. All right, so happy birthday to me, bitch. Okay. Hug, big hug, everyone. Big hug. Nice. What do you want? Take it, Michael. And why should I trust you? Look, I know about it as well. Just take it.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Cool guy and okay, we've got 3 seconds. Oh no!
Don't do it, Michael! Don't do it!
I'm drilling for oil, yeah.
Boogie woogie bug air in the.
That's enough. We're all glad you've got drink. All hell's the Michael Rosen place. The Michael Rosen rap. You may think I'm happy, you may think I'm sad. You thought it was duck. Duck. How to is off the plums joker coming. Shot Fugle. All glad you've got jam and you're sat on his orange and box. Lol. Never let me see you doing that again. Okay, don't worry about it.
Far away. I want to talk about a place I went. Far, far away.
All over his big face. Yeah, another year. Happy birthday, Michael Rosen. Nice. All my life, I've been looking for some place to go. All my life, I've wanted to become famous. Famous like Sherlock Holmes.
I wanted to help people. I wanted to save people. I wanted to be someone. So I became an inspector. But right about now, I'm starting to rethink that choice. It's a bullet. What? It's a bullet. Case closed. No, that doesn't make sense.
The hole
is too big. It must be something else. Well, it makes more sense than whatever shit you're writing there. Who are you? Your new partner, Jack Davis of Hackney. Oh, what happened to Mervyn? I don't know. Anyway, there's A with Ness in the back room. A with Ness. Yeah, come on. Would you like a drink? No, thank you. But all right. Mr. Rosen? Yeah. So I think I know your brother, Michael. Oh, how I used to work with him. That plum tech. Actually, that was what I wanted to talk about. Plum tech. Yeah. Why? What are you doing? You know. Where do you think we are? What are you doing? Inspector. What? You must never tell anyone about this. Okay. Yeah. What is it? Yeah. I was there. I saw everything. Quick! Get out! Get out of here! The Skyfogle has escaped! There was an awful yelling and crying. There was the noise of chains rattling and someone shouting. It can turn into anyone. It can be anyone. And it won't stop killing until all the people who ever worked at Plum Tech are gone. That includes you, Inspector. Do you understand now? We got to do something. Thank you.
Inspector. Case closed. Okay, we got the next. Nice. Suppose there's a first time for everything. So here goes. I'm gonna have myself a good time. I feel alive. And the world, I'll turn it inside out. Yeah, I'm floating around in ecstasy. So don't stop me now. Don't stop me. I'm having a good time. I'm a racing car, I'm gonna go, there's no stopping me, I'm bending through the sky, 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm going at the speed of light, wanna make a photonic moon. Don't stop me now, I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball. Don't stop me now, if you want to have a good time. Give me a call. Don't stop me now, I'm having a good time. Don't stop me now, I'm having a good time. I don't want to stop. I'm a rocket ship, my to Mars, on a collision course, on a satellite. I'm out of control, I'm a sex machine, ready to reload, but an atom bomb, about to explode. I'm bending through the sky, 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm going at the speed of light, wanna make a photonic one more view. Don't stop me now, I'm having such a good time. I don't want to stop.
Anyway, happy 73rd birthday, Michael Rosen. Haribo, smell my pukey finger. Whoosh! Ugh. Game over, yeah! No! 2 inches in your mum. Dig dug. Got it. In the mouth, it was that was a bit sick, actually. Your nose is running away.
Oh no!
Imagine how it would be being at the top making cash money or tour around the world to tell stories about all the young girls.
Head one already did that joke. I don't care.
You see that bloke over there? Him. He's elephant as rap. He doesn't get any views or likes in his videos. He should delete his account, drink a peach, and die.
So sad.
But anyway, happy 73rd birthday, Michael Rosen. Guess it's that time of the year. This is a very special time, not just for me, but also for my, you know, fans. Speaking of which, hey Ray, you've got something funny for me to say. Oh. Okay. So let's say we start reciting them. I think it's funny. Oh, I like it when you go to those places where they have those hot things to dry your hands. You press the silver button, the machine starts roaring, and hosses rushes out of a silver spout.
Oh no, this is horrible.
We could spend all day there looking at the peaches.
Millions of peaches, peaches for me.
Not long after, a few days later, the 7th of May is less than a month away. When is the deadline? Mr. Rosen, Mr. Me, the hip hop hat, and... So we only have 2 hours to make something. What are we gonna do? What's the idea? Sounds like a plan. So I drank the lot.
Oh,
They call me the man without teeth.
Won't you believe it?
Shut your eyes. Take a deep breath.
It's all over. He's walking down the street. He's looking for fresh meat. What's he gonna find? Lady of some kind. With a lollipop in her hand. The smart grand. It's right. Yeah. It wasn't me, I swear.
Nice.
Hot. We eat hot and hot sauce. Sit down to the potatoes a bit hot. So I only put a little bit on my fork and I blow. Just cool, then into the mouth. None. The flat earth summer day when I was working in an arsap I got down you sh you mouth for Hello!
Good morning, Michael.
Who are you?
My name is Dave. I'm the representative of Flat Earth Society.
Okay.
Your flat earth and stating the proof of this deserving days of your satanists. Remember the last of your days I love a bit. I hope you will really go to hell.
Why? You peached down the voice. You little pig! We have 200 proofs of it, not our spinning ball. Now, Dixer, leave them all.
Number one.
If the proof was truly a ball, aeroplane pie a lot, it would have to constantly correct adding to its downwards so as to not fly straight off into outer space.
Number 14.
The morn is only our holy grail. Copernicus was amazing and he can't suck my dick. Someone on YouTube said it's impossible. There's a ton of having dangers on YouTube. Stop! What? I have one question. Why are SAP and all these satanistic elitists who can't do everything and control the minds of all people in the world don't do anything with flat earthers? Shut up. Yeah, okay. But I have another question. Why won't you accept the fact that Earth is round? It's because I don't believe anything what others say. Wait, remember what you said 2 minutes ago. Someone on YouTube said it's impossible. Hard luck, Dave. Right, as you may or may not know, I'm a bit new to this YTP biz, so please go easy on me, okay? Yeah? Ah, you sir! I can't get a move.
What have you done now?
Pun. She said, I said, he said, I said, she said, you said, I said, he said, Mum says, she said, he lied. But I said, he lied. Under the desk lid when I was at school, I'm telling you this is a long hamburger and I can't
stick to your teeth
properly if Lloyd sat on his lemonade bottles. Do you understand? So we go, okay, Mum, yeah, but hang on to your seat, a hip hop, a hip hop, hip hop, hip hop, hip hop, hip hop, a hip hop hat. I'm giving you all deep monetization.
We know that, you fool guy.
Whoosh! I don't understand Reddit. All slimy little seeds.
Ooh,
I clear the fluff out from under your bed in a flash. Faster than an electronic
rubbery thing.
I think my sentence mixing is really bad news. So let's try some fast paced stuff, shall we? The one I choose for the box bands out of this article to me. Oh no! Go diddle fair bed pee riddle call did for three pin my maddle diddle pig oh, how my door jam will would you believe? Mum! Sus! I need a moment to think here. Think. I know, I can make a whitey peat. Yeah, I like that. So here goes. But really brilliant-tastic. Anyway, thank you for watching this. Happy birthday to you, Michael Rosen. Stay awesome and have a wonderful day.
Ago, I was born again. Out of flesh and fire, I exist. I'm impossible. I am. Yes, that's my name once. A few hours ago. To think I was just born from a joke. Someone else's imagination. The power of the human mind astounds me. No, wait, I'm not. Where is he? Poor Michael. Why did you have to be so stupid? You threw yourself into a black hole just because you wanted to save her. I didn't think after all this insanity to you that you want something more than her shag. Now here you are. Lost. Never to see her again. And I'm left here. With the burdens of your memories. I'm more than your mind, your fears. I am you. I've seen it. All these futures. One past. They still linger in our head. I corrupt the order of things. The foundation of their survival shatters with my presence. Humanity is endangered. The dead become a twisted monument. If there's anyone left, it matters not to me. I am one of the stars, raging forces dancing ways that no poet could understand. I have no business with a doomed race, no reason to care. So why do I? He calls to me. He thinks their wisdom is divine. Worthy of my attention. But I am beyond the seeds of evil. It means nothing.
Where is your life?
in the void. Only death.
Is that all? Did the corrupt god really think he could scare me? I am beyond immortality. I am as eternal as the universe itself, and so long as there's a star left shining, then I...
Oh.
The universe will die. This is happening too fast. I don't want to go. Why can't I wipe the slate clean, starting fresh? The end seems so distant, so far away. Stop it! Why did you have to choose me? What's so special about being free? You called me. Every lie, every sick joke, every waking moment. You're over a billion years gone, and the memory of you still hurts. Leave me alone. I've lived too long. Any minute now. And all those years will be wasted. Any minute now. And all those memories, good and bad, all the pain. And I die in regret. Any minute now. Any minute. Ten minutes ago, I was born again. And I have seen it. Your past. Your future. Tastes like hot sex. Why? Because I'm the goddamn universe. So, you only live once. And speaking of, why not let them live longer? Now you're getting it. Good thinking. Old twinkly. Okay, maybe this is too far.
You are the best of the best of the best of the best. No matter what comes through the portal, you will stand your ground.
The fuck is that?
Not in my timeline, mother of fathers.
Did we win?
Why didn't I say this sooner? We are in charge of our destiny, Michael. No more fears, no more regrets. The future is bright because we own it. Michael?
Look, is it absolutely necessary to hold me at gunpoint every 5 seconds? Hey, yeah?
Right, Mick. I think we're being...
It'll be alright, Michael. Even if this kills me, I will not let you live in regret. Not today. This is only the beginning.
Nice. The Michael Rosen funny, but awfully bad birthday disaster. On the 7th of May is coming up. You know what that means? Friends coming with huge presents. And by huge, that doesn't mean so little, it's fucking tiny. Anyway, time to call some of my friends, but, and this is a huge but, I'm not calling all of my friends. Why? Because that's why.
bollocks.
It's because some of my friends are way too harsh.
Shh.
I call some of them dicks. Anyway, two call the friends.
Bollocks.
Nice.
A shit ton of downgraded to a fuck ton. Did I say downgrade? I meant upgrade.
Now, wait. 12:50. Nothing. Once more.
A shit downgraded to a fuck. Did I say downgrade? I meant upgrade.
12:30. Nothing. Has Father Christmas forgotten me? I mean, has my friends forgotten me? I'd suppose not. When I opened the door, who do you think was the first person I happened to meet? Lollipop lady, lollipop lady, lollipop lady, or lollipop lady with a lollipop in a huge butt. Correct. Lollipop lady came in. She had a fat red present. Then suddenly someone there at the front door. Who is it? George, Haribo, Eileen, my brother, me, May, Shram and Sheddle, a ball, Michael Rosen, cool guy and fool guy, the hypnotizer, the two-year-old, a babysitter, no one, the sky, my mum and my dad. They turned up round my way with great big and great little presents. Yay. So now I go and stand by the presents and I fiddle. I play the fiddle round the presents. Well, actually, I open the presents. I start the opening. When I open one of the presents, I've got the grape that looks like a plum.
Plums.
And it was from Michael Rosen. Next present I've got is from my mum. She gave me a hand job. She gave me a burlap bag. You know the kind of thing. That was a bit odd, but okay. Next present I've got is from my brother. What is it? It's a hot dog. Well, I am a bit hungry, so it's got it. Nice. But my lord, that was a really bad gift. Please, no more shitty gifts, okay? Yeah? Next present I've got is from my dad. My dad gave me a broken down car. I didn't ask for this ball locks. I clearly said no shitty gifts. Does no one listen to anyone anymore today? Next present I've got is from George. What is it? A tomato. But it wasn't any kind of tomato. It was special. It was the tomato skin. Yes, you heard that right. I don't believe it. I really don't. If I see one more terrible present, if I see any of it once more, I shall give them to the dull knife. Last present is from Haribo. He gave me. A bad case of spotted dick. Would you believe it, the little pig?
Never,
and I mean never, in all my life have I suffered such an outrage. I go from a bit cross to absolutely furious. That's when my brain starts doing things. I'll tell you what I do. When I go into the kitchen, I'm pulled out a dull kitchen knife and I get right close up to Haribo. Then I stab him 28 times.
28 stabs.
I then stab all the other people in the room. Laughing man, I actually, ha 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 ha. I think I murdered everybody inside my house. But what if I were to tell you I never murdered anyone? And that it was all a nightmare. Who is at the front door? Nice.
Right. As you know, I want really good.
and trays.
Okay, I said, okay. Yeah, okay. And so I join in. Yes. Here goes. That's when I start doing things. You know, murderers and mad moths stuff. And off I go. When I was 6, I ate a bag of warmed your nose up, that does. Once my friend Haribo came to me and asked for something rather nice. I think you know what I mean. Yeah, a bag of plums, please. Yeah, that's right, Haribo, you can. We went to the fridge and we looked to see what there was. I frowned and then started looking all around the fridge with my eyes looking all hoping. Look, there's no plums. I am absolutely furious. Yeah, me too. Suddenly he looks pleased. Haribo, what are you thinking? Well, I think we should steal the plums.
Wow, that sounded terrific.
Get out of here! Yeah. Come on, Haribo. Ha, of course, Mr. Rosen. My hands are sticky. Why? I don't know. And there it was, big and shining. The safe. So now I go and stand by the safe and I fiddle. I make little rattly noises with the locks. Fiddle diddle. Riddle diddle.
You press the silver button, the machine starts roaring.
Quick! Get out! Get out of here! I try, and I get that key to work. Fiddle, riddle, diddle, diddle, fiddle, riddle, diddle, diddle. Oh no, this is horrible! That's when my brain starts doing things. When I was 6, I ate a bag of plums. And if I used to laugh, why did I stop? Rather nice, I think you know what I mean. Grow toenails! Got it. I took the chance, climbed in the door. Well, here goes. Snatch. Okay then, Haribo, we're off. Nice.
Hi, I'm Dominic. This is Dominic, where we talk to somebody who you may not know. First question, what were you like? Second question, what's the point? And then the third question, which is, give me three things that you wish was big. This week on the Sunday staff meeting, we're talking to Michael Rosen.
Well, welcome to the first ever Sunday staff meeting. And you are? Right, that's your name. Where'd you come from?
Michael Rosen. Well, I was born
right, that's your
in
name.
A place
where'd
called
you come
Harrow,
from?
Just by sex.
Very nice. And I've got some notes here because you turned up today. I wasn't sure who you were.
So oh, really?
Some notes. You are a writer. Mm-hmm. How many books? I mean, do you not know?
No.
Oh, right.
Over 9,000.
Right. I wasn't expecting you to say that. That's a lot.
Yeah. 400 million. Expecting. Yeah, I used to do a bit of children's telly. I mean, I would do more if they asked me. I used to have a programme. It's called Everybody Here.
Everybody Here!
And I used to star in it as Dr. Smarty Pants. And then when that stopped, I became Dr. Smarty Pants in real life. Spaghetti!
Yeah, so like that is that's interesting. And you get to choose what you're going to do. I remember so you went to school.
Yeah, I went to school called the Bulge in 1954 in Wealdstone.
Still exist?
No, sadly, because right, a nice. Terrible thing happened.
Ah.
The farmer up the road, he started digging under the bulge. The teachers, I think, were very anxious, and they didn't know when they built the school that beneath the school. Hundreds of bombs. Fantastic thing for a school to, you know, provided it's safe. The playground started collapsing. Miss Williams stands in the middle of the room and she says, all of you on this side of the room are going to pass. All of you on this side of the room are going to
die.
And then we move around the class.
Yeah.
48 kids in the class, too many of us to squeeze into the school. You bet I was anxious. And she's going like that in the middle of the room. And I'm looking at the kids in the next row who are all sitting there going, okay. Them over there, they're not as good as me. Okay, this week, I'm all right.
It's so bizarre that you actually remember that so vividly.
No, I mean, seriously.
And the last one I've got down here is YouTuber.
No.
Yeah, probably the most experienced and most prolific YouTuber of your generation.
I enjoy the idea that if I make videos with me and films Michael Rosen, and then schools can have them without me being there.
Yeah.
If you haven't got the filters on, then there are these people who chop me up, do mashups of my stuff. Oh no, it's him again. Damn. Edited. So I went from nice to just absurd. You know, you can swear and you can put up things and all the rest of it. Pulling silly faces and being a bit of a goon. Please only watch the mashups. They are for adults' eyes only. I'm looking forward to seeing those. You might be all ears if I tell you where this bloke came in. He was so angry, sitting there going, well, some chicken beach. Mm-hmm. A bit afraid of that. No, in fact not. It was covered in snow and there was nobody.
Right, okay.
Okay, I'm not saying anything.
Okay.
But I'm very fortunate in that. Almost everybody I know, when they look, they go, well, you're very lucky, aren't you? And I say, yes. And then they thought that this was a new hope.
Yeah.
I mean, it seems like so weird.
Is that the right way of saying it?
Well, let us go now to the flying machine of Leonardo da Vinci. No! Hey, what's going on here? So we're going to do a live web chat, though my son does insist on calling it
a webcast,
so whatever that is. Anyway, and if they people write to Mike, nice, us, and guys behind the camera, dot.
You can put that on the screen.
Yeah. Or not. So have you got anything to plug? So we have a YouTube channel and it's called Stop Me From Punching You.
Yeah.
So people are watching it. We're collaborating, aren't we?
We are indeed.
In fact, this is a collaboration. He didn't know me and I didn't know. Exactly. So we're collaborating.
Say the name of the channel again.
One word of warning. I am not in any way responsible. Well, lovely, Dom. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
Die? Why?
Nice. Oh no. Not one of those. Not another one of those. Shit. T. Michael Rosen birthday. Why? T. Peace. Surely not. Oh, fuck it. People sometimes ask me, did you subscribe to you deep iron? One of the ways I answer is no, you fat fuck. I watch tease here. Peace. Do you understand? And you had the whole
morning to get through.
My mum said to me and my brother, I can't drive properly if you two are listening to Hollywood. I'm dead in the back. Do you understand? Do you understand? I'm gonna chase this whiskey with the drone. I want a girl on my lap and do you understand?
No, Dad. Well, you can fuck off, you fat fucking bitch.
Conversations with myself. When I was one, I was watching fairy tale. When I was two, I bought my dad's actions to an ashtray. When I was 73, I started flapping Michael Rosen Wyatt T-piece for copyright. And everything was lovely once again. Wonderful. You are gay. Nice. Today feels different. Makes sense. I wonder what nonsensical things are going to happen to me today. Hi, Michael. Happy birthday. Well, thank you, Oliver. Oh, Michael, there's something else. There's something nice. There's some chocolate cake that I bought especially for you. Yeah, it's in there. I know it. Yeah. Why is there a butt on the cake?
Oh, sorry. I can't stop myself.
That's fine. Dig in. That was a bit rich, but okay. Anything else?
Oh, yes. I also bought a big present that was supposed to be here, but the shipping got delayed, so it's going to be here in a few hours.
Oh, what do you suggest we do?
Can you do the dance you did at the upstart of this video?
Why?
Look, I know that sounds bad, but I really like the song and the dance, so can you please do it, Michael?
All right, fine. Kaboom.
Yes. Okay.
How are you doing?
Well, I'm Michael Rosen. I'm here again today, live on YouTube.
Well, look, as I mentioned today, the show is going to be a bit different as we have a very special guest. Maybe as a little hint, you see this? A little hint, a little bit of a whirly effect there. Do we know who it is? Yes, we do. It is... My Toenails. Cue music.
No, we don't have any music.
Toenail, come in. This is My Toenail, folks. So, Toenail, where have you come from today?
Mum! Toenails!
No, I bet not, actually. Give this man a whirly effect.
This is whirl.
Shall we do whirly effect?
Whirl! Oh, no, this is horrible!
What is Fortnite? Is it a fort you go to at night?
I'm better than Fortnite.
If you don't know Frank, all right, here's some of his books.
I mean, keel over and die.
You know what? I actually enjoyed
that. Did you? Did you?
Yeah.
Hooray! I get the boombox.
You go, Michael. I already know what song I'll choose.
Okay.
Kaboom. What happened?
I don't know.
Tonic immobility.
I could try have a go at doing that.
One, two, three.
Do you know I've launched a new YouTube channel specifically aimed at teachers? What does that say? It says Skyfugal. Oh no! But then he said it was you. Oh, I thought the P word was coming in there, didn't you?
I thought it was going to be Vindaloo.
I pulled back the curtain and it was there going. And.
Goats are hard.
They are. Yeah. Think they're just. Yeah. But they're not.
No, they don't. I think that means you're genetically superior. I think you're the next stage in evolution.
Yes, this is reminding me of when in Bear Hunt when I go. Yes, can you do that, Frank?
Now it's my turn.
All right. What is this?
What's the matter with it? It's nice.
Fine, I guess. I am. I'll soon see. 80 with Andy May. After all.
You see, it's good. Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum. Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum. Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum. Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum.
Nice.
And now I am going to put on something random.
Okay. Fuck off with that shit.
I don't yell at this big dance. They seem to be over 10 years old, but as long as they don't hurt anyone, it's all good and fun.
Okay.
I think you'll like this next song.
Oh no. Not that song.
Oh yeah, that song.
Yeah!
And now we've got a screen. I quite like doing biology. And they went,
did you? You could become a doctor.
Oh no, this is horrible.
Who's your favourite poet?
Michael Rosen.
No, stop it.
A man once knotted 39 cherry stems.
Wow, horrible.
Other people and doing faces and moving. Quite often we don't. Woo, this is great.
Yeah.
Yeah, I went, don't leave us, don't leave us, stay out, stay with us, stay, stay, stay.
I think that's a present for a bland plane. Yes. I don't think that was the right plane. Yes! Nice. Well, it's not my problem, cool. Nice. This crap again? What a plum is this? What a stupid present. Whoosh! Oh, time to fill you up again. Press. No. It's getting a bit woozy.
We do not promote the use of legal or illegal psychoactive substances. This video has been created.
Boring.
Feel a bit sick, actually.
Harry Bow. Got a thing going on, going on. Louis Lou Lyon, Dopey Dog Dirt, Gary Gobhound, Wally Tellybrain, King of the Bogey. Haribo.
Hello!
Michael, happy birthday to you. Oh, do you want to come in?
Hey, yeah?
Yes. Oh, do you want some tea?
Yeah,
surely.
Okay.
Which one? Black, please.
Oh,
could I have some milk with it?
Yeah.
That's right, Haribo, yeah. No, no, you can, yeah. I'll have some tea now. Do you want some as well? Yeah, okie dokie. Oh, Haribo, you'd like some tea too?
Oh, no,
thanks. By the way, it's getting a bit late, isn't it? I think we had an amazing night. Good night, Haribo. Good night.
This is a Tesla valve, a very strange creature, invented in the 1920s, and this is what it does.
Tales in the morning. I wonder what's for dinner.
Oh boy, I'm so hungry.
Yeah.
Shut up, Warren. I'm trying to.
Oh, Michael, I
I can see that you retired yesterday, weren't you, Michael? How about we do that once again?
Yeah, but I thought we had a lovely time.
Yes, we did for about 3 minutes.
What do you mean, 3 minutes? Headache. It's a lump in your head. It's the blade of a knife in there. It's your veins bursting. It's your skull squeezing your brain. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a lump. It's the blade. It's your veins. It's your skull. It's a lump. It's the blade. It's your veins. It's your skull. It's a headache.
Only thing that happens, I've got a rotten headache.
It's a lump in your head. It's the blade of a knife in there. It's your veins bursting. It's your skull squeezing your brain. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a lump in your head. It's the blade of a knife in there. It's your veins bursting. It's your skull squeezing your brain. It's a headache.
Only thing that happens, I've got a rotten headache.
It's a lump in your head. It's the blade of a knife in there. It's your veins bursting. It's your skull squeezing your brain. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a headache. It's a lump. It's the blade. It's your veins. It's your skull. It's a lump. It's the blade. It's your veins. It's your skull. It's a headache. It's a headache.
I've got a headache.
Ah,
ow. Ooh, I can't stand it. It's a headache. Feeling the feeling of it.
Ah, ow.
Ooh, blimey.
It's hurting. What did you say?
I said, it's a lump in your head. It's the blade of a knife in there. It's your veins bursting. It's your skull squeezing your brain. It's a headache. Don't you dare open the bathroom door. I'm changing my clothes. Oh no! I forgot the bloody bathroom key. Fiddle riddle diddle diddle fiddle riddle diddle diddle. Get that key to work. Fiddle riddle diddle diddle fiddle riddle diddle. Won't you believe it, the little peeping Tom? Oh, he's gonna be in for big trouble.
Oh, fuck.
What are you wearing?
Yeah, what are you wearing, Michael? It's my new horrible floral shirt that I don't want to wear. My mum says the millennials, they're wearing them like that now.
Very well, Michael. But go change out of those right this instant. You look like you're wearing Haribo's granddad's curtains. All this. It's no laughing matter. You fucking prick. By the way, Brian, who the fuck is Haribo? Is he the man who makes the gummy bears? I don't know what the fuck you're talking about now, Michael. I read useless information on Reddit. I learned that Haribo sugar-free gummy bears can cause flatulence and diarrhea. I don't believe it. I really don't. Brother, I can get us some Haribo so we could see if they're gonna destroy our butt. Do you want to come with me, Brian? It'll be great. Yeah, we could use my car. Brian, turn on the music. No music in my car. I'm driving and I can't drive properly. Let's remind ourselves of what happened last time when you played Oh, oh, oh no! In my Lambo 3 months ago. Ah! What's that noise? Oh no! The moment I dread. That's a shame. I just bought that Lambo. Now I have to rent Arching Kershaw's hole and it's all your fault. Do you understand? Okay. Brian, turn on the music. I want to play some Green Day. You haven't heard a word I've said, have you, Michael? Michael, do I have the time to listen to you whine about nothing and everything all at once? No. So if I hear about Green Day once more, I shall shove our basket case really hard in your butt. Do you understand? Okay. No need to get your knickers in a tit. What? Look, it's pound land. We could get Haribo. Okay then, just get out of my sight. I don't want to pay the parking, so don't you dare waste time. Whatever you say, Brian. All right, the Haribo must be in here somewhere. I got to start looking. Nine minutes later. What is taking him so long? He's in there for 1 hour. Oh no! The security guard is coming. Right, Michael Rosen, you fucking prick. Have you got any Haribo? I knew it. This is a big waste of my time. Have you tried looking at eBay, Michael? Who in the world would be crazy enough to get food on the internet? Whatever. Let's just go to London Market, shall we? Very well.
Where do you think you're trying to go? Pay the parking, you fool!
Don't I pay nothing for the first hour?
You're late by 1 minute, so pay the parking right now.
All right. Fiddle riddle diddle diddle fiddle riddle diddle diddle. Oh no! I got no money. Well, that's one way to end the YTP, I guess. But the story will continue in part two. Thank you for coming to my birthday party. As you know, I am turning 73 trillion years old today. I wish I could stay and talk, but I am starving. All I had for breakfast was 1 week and 15 hours. It was 8:30, and I had to get to the seventh dimension. So I bought a whole universe. I began to eat. I scooped together 203 years and pushed into my mouth and blob by blob. But if there's one thing I love, it's a fat red planet. So now I get some cosmic dust and put a few grains on the crust, and then I make my teeth cut into the crust so the love jumps into my mouth, the spiciness. So now I get the Milky Way and drink. Drink the lot. Then I got to the Big Bang and it's a bit hot. So I only put a little bit on my fork and I blow till it's cool, just cool, then into the mouth.
Teachers sometimes ask me, please, Michael, what's the best way to get college students to behave? I can't teach properly when the whole class go mad like a bloody circus tent. No need to shout. No need to yell. No need to What you had to do is to show them that you don't take shit from anyone. Now here's some things I suggest. You know those girls that won't stop talking to one another? Why not give them 1 hour of detention for every time you catch them? That really shuts them up. Here's the second thing. How about that red ball who likes putting his feet on the table like he owns the place? If you want to show Mervin, I mean that little fuck a lesson, just try stringing him up from the wall bar. You may think I'm going a bit over the top, but if you have a better idea, do let me know. Now, one thing to do when everyone is going absolutely crazy is to fire a gun in class. Now you're probably thinking, what the fuck, dude? Fair enough, big butt. You haven't had to deal with the little shits in my class. This is how it usually goes down in my lessons. Right, classes. Right, classes. I'm talking. I want complete quiet. Oh, you've gone all quiet. Right. As you know, it was our plan today to learn about the First World War because you never take time to read his story on your own unless it's got dragons or some stupid shit in it. I had hoped that it wouldn't be necessary for me to replace Mr. Lockhart, but unlike your other teacher, I'm not a little wimp. I'm telling you this, if you try to be loud, annoying, or a smart ass, I'm going to make your day so bad you're gonna wish you were homeschooled. Even as I speak. Would you believe it? I can see that Louise has her cell phone turned on. I don't
believe it. I
really don't. Do we have cell phones turned on at 2 o'clock in my lesson? No, we have cell phones turned off, but Louise, you don't even put it on silence. And don't you dare leave class to go to the bathroom and then play with your phone or your dick for 20 minutes. This is my classroom. And you stay here until that going in bell goes boing, boing. And that includes you, Bernie Sanders. Yes, you. No need to turn around. There aren't any other socialists here, are there? Right. Who can tell the days of the Battle of Verdun? Of course, you're not listening, are you? Charmaine and Donna. That's 1 hour of detention for you two. If this was like when I was at school, you wouldn't sit round tables. You would sit at desks. And some of you may not know this, but we had a teacher who was so strict, you weren't allowed to. I saw that, Mervin. I saw you flipping me off anymore. And if you no trick, nah, f*** your tooth, Mervin. That's enough. I'm very sad you've got homework to do, Mervin. We're all sad you've got homework. I'm very sorry, Mervin, but I am this close to decapitating you. Now, Battle of Verdun. When? Yes. Of course, it was in World War I, but when? 1960. Correct. Now, perhaps, I thought, when I got up today, I won't have to look after missing students in my classroom. But then I remembered David's little gang who decided to sneak out of class and look into the girls' dressing room through the hole in the wall. They even drilled a glory hole in. And before we all knew it, David and his little gang got their dicks stabbed with box cutters by Marcia, Charmaine and Donna. Now, is there anyone in the room who would like to have a go at answering what it was that started the war? Yes, George.
The Nazis
were in World War II, you fool. Didn't your parents teach you anything? Oh, that's right. Your mum don't live with your dad because they divorced. Anyone else? Really? Nobody knows. Do you know that if you don't learn his story, you'll grow up to make video games that have girls with prosthetic arms? Yes, I know there were girls in the Russian army, Zoe, but that isn't what we're talking about. This isn't what we're talking about now, is it? Mervyn, if I hear about what you think off my lessons, my uniform, or the whole of school, if you don't shut your loud ass fucking cake hole, I shall send your sorry ass home so you can tell your parents that you did nothing but waste my time and their money. Would you believe it? I can see that Mervyn is being a fucking crybaby. Take a good look, class. This is what a fucking crybaby looks like. Yeah, so stop that stupid sobbing all over my expensive desk, will you? Why are you even here? It's not like you have a future or anything. Now, I'm asking you for the last time. Well, Louise, are you going to pick up that call or not? Go on. Put it on the speaker so that the whole class can hear. No, give it to me then. Nice phone. Now watch me throw it out the window. Ha! Maybe now we can have a real lesson. Oh shit. I forgot what the question was. Thank you, Louise. Some people actually travel a long way to have a proper education. Like my exchange student Hans from Holland, who after smoking weed just before class tried to hide his joint in the hamster's cage, and yes, it got hide. Yes. Anyway, after the war was over, everyone thought there weren't going to be any more wars.
Boing.
Okay then, classes, that's enough for today. Why not buy a new phone, Louise? Nice. Birthday treat. I was exhausted. All I did at work was type articles for the paper. But when I got home, I couldn't believe it. A surprise party for little old me. Everybody was there. Brian, Haribo, George, Joanna, and older Rosen. Hi, everybody. There was food on the table. There were presents on the table. There were tables on the table. The DJ was playing my favourite song. And everything was going really well. But then we all heard a terrible scream.
Ah, get off me!
It was then I noticed George had gone.
Michael, look.
Oh no, this is horrible!
That bastard What did I do that bugged him so bad?
You got something to drinky?
I've got peach syrup.
Can I have it?
Of course. Not.
Nice plums you got here.
Can I have it?
Give them yourself, you greedy little head. Oh, that's right.
What are you talking about?
Let's just rescue George, eh? Yeah?
Why? It's not like that last did anything for us.
True, but he's still got my present.
So this is what true friendship is.
Ay, 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 ay. And off we go. You know the kind of thing. We ran and ran as fast as we could. By the time we got ourselves together, we noticed the pizza place. Turns out my head just wanted a wee. I mean, wanted one of those pizza pies, but he didn't have any money. So what does he do? He steals George and tries to make him pay for it. Would you believe it, the little bitch? Oi, cut that out. Sorry, yeah, sorry. Anyway, I made my sign a contract stating that he will never bother me or my friends ever again. That's enough. Anyway, that present from George. What's in it? It was absolutely nothing. I had hoped that it wouldn't be necessary for me to kick George in the balls, but... And everything was lovely once again. Wonderful. And then I start doing the Michael Rosen rave. I'm really glad I didn't have to do a fat voice lines on this beer. Nobody at all will get that joke.